As we were watching one of the dramas earlier, of the missionaries from Fiji who were being beaten up while they were ministering in South America, I looked around the room and saw people begin to wipe with tears. I saw this woman in the second row here, and this woman in the third row, as you begin to cry. And I want you to know that your tears shall turn into tears of joy. And I want to say to all those that are here tonight, and those who have prayed, those who have wept for the souls of nations, your tears shall be turned to cheers of joy. As the great preacher Charles Spurgeon once said, he said that tears are liquid prayers. God has seen the liquid prayers of Fiji, the sacrifices in Fiji, and your desire to send missionaries to the nations, and your tears shall turn into tears of joy. Hallelujah. Our text tonight will be out of Matthew chapter 5, verse 13 through 16. And if you'll read it in Fijian.
Chapter 5, verse 13 through 16. Koro sa taratoka na ulibunua sa asenga ni tambo nagrawa. Sa asenga talanga ni tutubagi na dina kamenga itoka rungu ni bora ni sila. Ene kena itutunga sa angi dinabira keda nga sa atikwe vale. Me daun rebaka kina na nomundo rarama ena matanra na tamata. Me raraida na nomundo ibalabala binaka. Kabaga roro roga tangana tamamundo sa atikwe melo malangi.
I want to take a moment to look at verse 16.
Tikina itiriga ono.
It says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. The key point here is that we would bring glory to our Father in heaven, doing good works without glorifying the Father is dead works. I was praying this morning, and I kept hearing in my mind, Fiji, your light is shining to the nations because you are glorifying your Father in heaven. You see, the first point is that we do good works, not just to do good works, but we do good works that others may see our good works to bring glory to our Father in heaven. We were taught by Dr. Cole, that the character of the kingdom of God emanates from the character of the king, or comes from the king. And so if we have the character of King Jesus, his kingdom is reflected through us. And if we're going to reach the world with a heart of compassion, we need to do those good works in a way that reflects Jesus Christ and brings glory to our Father in heaven. I was so blessed yesterday that Pastor Suli allowed me to be a part of the dedication groundbreaking of the foundation laying at the primary and secondary school facility, where hundreds of young people will be educated in the character of the kingdom of God, trained with excellence and in character, in practical things, but also in the character of God. This is a good work that will bring glory to the Father in heaven. All the testimonies I've been listening to this week of what God is doing through Fiji to reach nations, to fulfill the Great Commission. Many good works that bring glory to our Father in heaven. As I've seen and met our brothers from Cambodia and from Rwanda and
Vanuatu
and other places around the world, they truly are bringing glory to the Father in heaven, because the light of Fiji is shining to the nations and bringing glory to the Father in heaven. You see, we've been talking about a church with great kingdom authority. And Christian Mission Fellowship,
CMF,
and World Harvest Center, and churches throughout Fiji has become a church of Acts, the book of Acts. And the church that is in the book of Acts had God's authority as an apostolic church. An Acts church is a church that does the work of the apostolic. It lays foundations. It lays the foundation and prepares the way for God to move in corporate anointing. You see, this kind of church is a church that is sanctified and holy. The characteristics of that kind of church is not just sanctified and holy, but it's a church that's willing to be a serving church. It's a church that is a sacrificial church, that is willing to sacrifice of their time and talent and money to become seed for the soil of souls, and a sacrificial church that offers themselves on the altar of God for the sake of souls is a church that the Holy Spirit fire of God will consume, and His glory fill the temple. An Acts church that is an apostolic church, not only a sanctified and holy church, a servant and serving church, a sacrificial church, but a church that is a sending church. It's not a church that just enjoys the blessings of God, but a church that has received the mandate of God and the commission of God to fulfill the Great Commission.
Tekinan ang